to the desert.
Adventures in Beekeeping, April 8, 2024, Hidden Meadow. We're in the process of setting up cameras. This is the day of the eclipse. We are not in an area where we're going to have a total eclipse, but we want to get some information, some record, some data about what's happening at the entrance of the hive. The darkest part of the eclipse for us here at the Hidden Meadow is between 3:08 and 3:10. We will soon have a clock and some other videos. Bear with us as we set up videos. As you can see from the upcoming shadow, I'm not wearing my veil or my suit. The bees are not interested in me whatsoever. I do have fairly gentle bees, but these bees are super gentle. I don't feel threatened at all. Here we go, we're getting the second camera ready. The first camera is the one you're seeing now, pointed at the entrance from the side. The second camera will be pointed at the entrance from the top and out just a little bit so that you can see the bees flying in. Prior to this, it's kind of like been like a normal day that you might see. The bees coming and going, but now it is becoming more and more of a rush to get home as it gets a tiny bit darker and darker.
Hello everybody, welcome to Adventures in Beekeeping. My name is Dale and we are at the Hidden Meadow and it is Eclipse Day, April the 8th, 2024, and we're going to check out the hives. We already have broodminder beedar set up on one of the hives. Try not to get in that area so that will still be undisturbed. But on the far hive way down there, I've got a couple of cameras set up. We're gonna see what happens. I'm not in total eclipse space. It's about 96% or 99.6%. I'm really close. And so we're gonna see what the bees do at the hive. There's a lot of activity. Bees are coming in. It is getting dark. It's probably more than 50% right now. I'll see if I can get a little something to show you what it looks like as far as the duration of the eclipse.
a few beekeeper observations. There are no bees leaving the hive. All of the bees that we're seeing are coming in and going into the hive. This has been happening for some time and will continue until the darkest part of the eclipse for me, which is about 3:08. Occasionally, you will see a few bees with their abdomens up in the air fanning. I believe this is the bees fanning their nasal glands to tell the other bees where their home is and that they should come on home. There are a lot of bees on the landing board. They're all going in. Also notice at the same time, there's still a lot of bees in the air approaching the hive. I've seen a lot of bees going into this hive. A lot of bees. And so that makes me wonder if this hive is the happiest one.
My pinhole set up, it's a little after 3 o'clock. It's not focused very well, but you can see we're almost all the way there. Time is now 3:06. Looks to me like the bees are getting the word to come home. Get on home. All the hives look just like this. Birds flying over. Every once in a while I see a shadow of a bird.
cool. There's a breeze. It's so dark that my panel camera, you can barely see what's going on. Be getting brighter. Hello, it's almost over. Yeah, it's almost getting lighter as it gets brighter. Yeah, 14. 321. It's 3:26. It's almost over, as you can see from my pinhole camera. It's almost over. there's still more eclipse to go. It goes until 424. As far as the sky is concerned, and as far as like just walking around, it looks like a normal, regular day. And that's kind of the way the bees are acting, just normal, regular. As far as the bees are concerned, it's kind of a normal, regular day. They're just coming and going. Some are coming in with pollen, some are...
Lots of them are exiting because a lot of them came in. But they're not exiting really fast. Just exiting like normal bees. So I think as far as the bees are concerned, it's just a regular day. Spring day. So I'm going to stop all the cameras and head for the house. Thanks for watching. God bless and have a great day. I hope you had a great eclipse viewing. It's 3:39.